हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन बबीता साइंस ट्यूटोरियल। लेट्स कंटिन्यू अवर चैप्टर माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड इट्स अ फ्रेंड्स एंड को ऑफ अ क्लास 8 साइंस। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ अ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई टोल्ड यू दैट व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स। देन माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स which cannot be seen by the naked eyes are called the microorganisms and it is also called the microbes. Then if we will divide the microorganisms, then microorganisms are divided into the four groups. First one is the bacteria, protozoa, fungi and the algae. Okay, bacteria is the plural form. If we use the single bacteria or if we be talking about the only one bacteria, that is called the bacterium. Okay, single protozoa, protozoan, single fungi, fungus, and algae, alga. Then we can see that microorganisms are divided into the four major groups, that is a bacteria, protozoa, fungi, and algae. But beside this one, another microorganism is also, that is called the viruses. Okay, but this one is comes in the borderline. Okay, we cannot be say that it is a living things or a non-living things. That's why we can see that they lie on the borderline, dividing the living things from the non-living things. And you know, student, virus can divide only when it will enters in the living cells, such as a bacterium, plants or animals. Then we can say that bacteria needs a host. It when it is a present in the air, it is a non-living thing, and when it will goes inside the body or human body or any living cells, they start to divide. Okay students, and virus can obtain the food from the host cells. Then same thing, viruses also we cannot be seen with the help of the simple microscope. They also need a high power. We can see these viruses only under the electron microscopes. And it's a too small, students, we cannot be seen with a naked eye. That's like these all microorganisms, bacteria, protozoa, fungi, and algae. Same thing, viruses also we cannot be see with our naked eye. Let's start from the first one. First microorganisms is your bacterium. Okay students, see here, bacteria, the most simplest, common and the smallest form of life on the earth is the bacteria. Okay, and you know, I told to you earlier also, bacteria lives in the singles, it's not live in the colonies. Okay, and they are found everywhere, like air, soil, water, inside and outside our body also. Okay, then they can survive in the harsh conditions like the drought and heat. Means bacteria can survive in the worst conditions also. Okay, very hard conditions also. It means the bacteria can survive in the drought areas also and the heat areas also. That's why we can say that bacteria is found everywhere. Okay, in any conditions, bacteria can survive. And they are unicellular organisms. I already told you what's the meaning of the unicellular. Uni means one. Those organisms which are made by a single cell, that is called the unicellular and organism, unicellular organisms. And you know, students, most important thing is that bacteria has a cell wall also. In the senior classes, when you go in the class 9th and 10th, then you will study about this bacteria in the details. Now see here, they vary in sizes from 0.2 to 100 microns. Micron, students, it's a unit which we used for the very smallest organism. Okay, in the smallest organism we can use this unit. That's why we can use here 0.200 microns. Like in the distance we can use the kilometer, in the liquid when we measure we can use the liter, and if we measure any mass then we can use the kg. That's why we can here we use the microns, because bacteria is so small that we cannot be see with our naked eye. We can see only with the help of the microscope. That's why we can use the unit here, microns. And you know, bacteria can divide it on the basis of the different shape and sizes also. Now you see here, bacteria are divided into the three. First one, it's not a student rat. It's a wrong here. It's a rot. Okay, it's a rot. Then first one is a rot shape bacilli, or in the singular word we can use the bacillus. Second one is a spherical shaped cocci, and the singular is a coccus. And the third one is a spiral shaped spirillum, and singular is a spirillum. Okay, then see here, you will see the structure here. See here, this one is not a rat shape, it's a rod shaped bacteria. Rod means like this, stick like structure, okay, or cylindrical structure. That is called the rod shaped bacteria. And the bacilli is a one kind of the bacteria whose shape is a rod shape. Another is a cocci. Okay, cocci is also one kind of the bacteria which is shaped is a spherical shape, or we can say that it is a round in shape. Okay, spherical shape, that is called the spherical shaped. Okay, and spherical shaped bacteria is a cocci. Another is a spiral shaped or spirillum. Spiral shaped means those bacteria which is in the twisted form, spiral shaped. Okay, this is called the spiral shaped bacteria, or that is called the spirillum. Okay, then on the basis of the shape sizes, this bacteria is divided into the three types, that is a rod shaped bacilli, spherical shaped cocci, and a spiral shaped, that is a spirillum. In your book only three shapes are given, then you can study only this three shape. Now let's move to hosts. In the hosts, what it says here, that bacterial, plants or animals. Okay, bacteria have a features of both plants and animals. Why this is like that? Bacteria have a features of both plants and animals. See here, plant and animals are both are living things. Okay, plants has a cell wall, then animals also has a cell wall. Okay, the outer covering of the bacteria have a cell wall. That's why we can put the bacteria in the plants. Animals is a living thing, then bacteria is also a living thing. But in the plant, chlorophyll is present, but in the bacteria, chlorophyll is not present. In the plant, with the help of the chlorophyll, it can trap the sunlight, and the green color of the leaves is due to the only chlorophyll pigment. And this chlorophyll pigment is present in the chloroplast organelles, okay, which is important for the most plants to make their own food. The sizes, shapes, and general living habits are like a lower plant such as the algae and fungi. They want to say the bacteria's shape, size, and living habits. I told you what's the meaning of the habit. The place where microorganisms or organisms can live is called the habits. Are just like a algae and fungi. Okay, scientists have never entirely agreed to the classify the bacteria. Okay, on how to classify. Scientists are also not in the proper way not classify the bacteria, scientists can try to classify bacteria, and they have divided the bacteria into the two. Okay, bacteria is divided into the Actually, class 9, it's a divided in many, but you can see here it is a divided into the two parts. First one is the aerobic bacterium and another is a anaerobic bacterium. Aerobic bacteria are the those bacteria which can survive in the presence of a oxygen. I mean, they need oxygen for a respiration. But anaerobic bacteria are those bacteria which cannot be need any oxygen for survive. Okay, then anaerobic bacteria does not need oxygen, and aerobic bacteria needs oxygen. Okay, then the study of a bacteria is known as a bacteriology. Okay, the study of the microorganism, it is called the micro. What is what I told to you? The study of the microorganism and the scientist who can study this one, then I already told to you. Then we can say that the study of the microorganisms are called the microbiology, and the scientist who can studies the microorganisms is known as the microbiologist, and the study of the bacteria is known as a bacteriology. Then student, this was only about in this video I am explaining only the first one, that is a bacteria, and in the my next video I will explain you fungi. Till then you can understand this one all, what is a bacteria, how many types of bacteria, okay, what is the shape of the bacteria, where the bacteria are found, that is all very important. The study of the bacteria is called for. This much is very, very important. Then you can focus in this on this all points, okay, and you can make the notes of the notes on the bacteria also. Till then, bye and have a nice day.